The Wellington Cup was also 100 years old last season. The Trentham race has grown in importance over the last 20 years to the extent that it stops the clocks all over New Zealand on a Saturday in January, while top thoroughbreds match their talents over the stayers' distance. In 1942, the race was increased from 1.5 miles to 2 miles, and then this year, with metrics in, to 3,200 metres. In the last 10 years, there have been worthy winners of the Wellington Cup, but we'd just passed a period of greatness, and it's to one of those years that we turn first. Only two horses have ever won 3 Wellington Cups. The first was Saniska in 1890, 91, 92. The second was owned by D.W. Brown and ridden in all 3 cups by Bob Skelton.
Great sensation next on the inside, 9 furlongs to go, and they're followed in by Big Bill and Lavish Countess, then moving up on the outside of these as they go round that bend is Blue Blade. Mediterranean next, they go into the back half, the journey behind them. A length further back to Ruatori is followed in by Gay Depot, Don Felu travelling well next on the inside. Panda there travelling well next as they go down the back with 7 to go is Gay Felu. Kingdom next on the inside is followed by Conference Picaroon on the inside of these 2.5 lengths to straight time. And they go down the far side of the course and Flotella's pulled its way to the front and Stipulate's got up on the inside. These two, they show the way, 6 furlongs to go. They're followed by Spondulix and Big Bill. Blue Blade is right alongside of these. They're followed in by Arpa next on the inside. Surging next as they go to the 5 furlong peg is followed in by Astra Tecton behind them. Dandin's moving out from the fence is great sensation. Getting awfully placed though is followed by Mediterranean. Now they get up round, they've got 4.5 to go and the cup and Blue Blade has got away. He's out by 3 lengths from Stipulate on the inside of Flotella. A length further back to Spondulix and they're followed by Harper going a good race on the fence in Lavish Countess is followed by Astra. Big Bill is next with great sensation tacked in on the inside of these and surging just ahead of these two. And they're followed in by Tunku but Blue Blade is away on the lead by 6 lengths, just under 3 to go. Blue Blade the grey by 6 lengths from Stipulate at the moment. They make the home bend, 2.5 to go. Followed by Flotella in third place in Lavish County, showing up on the outside of Flotella. Great sensations worked away from the fence and they come past the 2 furlong peg. Blue Blade under the stick by 2 lengths at the moment now from Stipulate on the inside. Lavish County, and here's the top weight. Grand Sensation putting up a magnificent performance on the outer. A furlong to go. Stipulate on the inside and Great Sensation. Blue Blade in the end behind them had enough, followed by Lavish County with the top weight on the outside. Great Sensation and Stipulate, and Great Sensation's going to win it. 3 on end. He goes to the post to win a length and a half to Stipulate. Followed home then, listen to the crowd, followed by Blue Blade, Lavish Countess.
It's not often that a horse wins a major flat race and then 2 years later succeeds in a major steeplechase. But Eiffel Tower did it. In 1965, Midge Didham rode Bill Haslett's then 4-year-old to win the Wellington Cup. In 1967, Bill Hillis rode the then 6-year-old to take the Great Northern Steeples.
Five Minx is getting very handy to them in third place, and then a length further back to Dandini, who's still there on the inner with just under 3 furlongs to go, and they're closely followed by Kumai, then Calm Comet is showing up on the inside, and Eiffel Tower moving up there also, as they make their way round the bend, and Palisade has worked out from the fence, and they race round the bend towards the two. And as they hit the 2 furlong peg, I Minx is the leader from Trawler Man putting in an appearance. And there's Dandini looking to get through on the inside, and he does so in a stride or two. And it's Dandini now on the inside, and Eiffel Tower putting in an appearance, and Calm Comet and Trawler Man. I Minx hasn't got much room to make right, and behind the Moonfire is appearing on the scene, but he'd be too late. And at the moment, it's Eiffel Tower and Dandini together. Eiffel Tower doing better than Dandini. They race for the line, and Eiffel Tower goes away to win it. Bailing from Dandini, Calm Comet may have held the third, but by Umpire Trawler Man, then we've got
1966, Brian Andrews had his first success in the Wellington Cup when he rode the 5-year-old Red Crest to victory.
They make for the back, into the back for the mile. A link for the back to Friolian Umpire. The next one was Sail Away, ridden by W.A. Smith, going up on the outside of Umpire. A link for the back to John Derry, 3/4 of a length to Alaska, a link to Kasarook. A next for the back to Fleeting Moment, Golden Defoe, the next one on the inside. Golden Defoe was closely followed then by Grand Falou, then next on the inside then was Worthy Chat. They're followed then by Laramie on the inside, and Three Kings and Shady and Sparkling Maid, they bring up the rear. They go down the far side now and approach the 6 furlong peg, and after it is, he still bowls along in front. He shows the way by a link from Royal Biz, then a link to the back to Court Bell. It's been giving every chance and galloping well. Eiffel Tower has moved up on the outside of Court Bell. They're followed by Bandon, who's 3 out, and Baloo is further out. Sail Away must be about 4 wide as they gallop round to the 5 furlong peg, followed by Red Crest. Creolian just on the outside of Retress now with 4.5 to go. They're followed by Kasserup travelling fairly well up towards the middle of the field. Trip Joint is just on the inside of Kasserup. They pass the 4 furlong peg. John Derry and Umpire the next ones. They're followed by Grand Falloon making ground from the back. Then next on the inside is Alaska. Alaska followed then by Worthy Chat, Fleeting Moment, and then further back then Laramie. Laramie with Golden Defoe only with 2 behind it. 3 furlongs from home on the cut, followed then by Shady. And Sparkling May drops out the last of furlong, length and a half away. Now they make their way around in 2.5 from home, and Harper still there in front on the turn. Harper bailing from Royal Bird, who's pulled out the challenge. 2 furlongs to go. Court Bell being hurried up from a run on the inside, and they're followed by Eiffel Tower, last year's winner, and Kasserup coming home well down the outside and racing down to the furlong peg. Harper's bewildered a wee bit, and it's left to Eiffel Tower to hit the front from Kasserup challenging Royal Bird. Court Bell in behind them. Red Crest and Clip Joint coming home brilliantly on the outside. They're followed by Three Kings, but at the moment Eiffel Tower and Royal Bird and away on the outside. Red Crest, and it's Red Crest and Eiffel Tower photo finish with Clip Joint right with a pair of them.
1967, a 4-year-old, Michael Malloy, began a run of victories for that age group when, ridden by M.A. Long, he prevailed at Trentham.
Followed by Jen High, a length to Kasserup next on the inside, followed by Polo Prince, the next one, Royal Sheen, and Royal Sheen has been joined by Lucy Gray, dashing up in about 6th place as they get to the 7, 3/4 of a length away then to Tarim, followed by Red Siren. Michael Malloy sees a gap and goes right for it, and they're followed then by Band on half a length away. A length further back to Eiffel Tower, then Wakamar Palisade has left the rail to go in between these two, and they're followed by Midnight Kiss next on the inside. They pass the 6 furlong peg. Fremont is starting a run up towards the middle of the field, is followed over on the outside by Mr. Fagan improving. A length further back to Kyrene, they start on the big bend and 5 to go. Balu is the next one, followed by Matawira Reacher, the next one followed by Vera, 2 lengths too terrific, and 3/4 of a length further away to Geyserland at the rear. They make their way across the top and 4.25 to go when Lucy Gray has reached the front. The 4 furlong peg, it shows the way from Harper, Jen High, 3 wide. A length further away to Honestly, getting a beautiful trail on the inside of Bright Chief, and they're followed then by Kasserup, appearing to be in a wee bit of trouble there as they make their way on round of the 3 furlong peg. Then Michael Malloy making a dive for another gap, and they're followed in behind them then by Mr. Fagan. Eiffel Tower's about 6 places back on the rail, and Palisades taking the widest way home back in about 10th place on the turn, and a 2.25 to go, and Jen High hits the front of the 2 furlong peg from Harper, still there on the rail, and Bright Chief making another run at them, and they're followed by Michael Malloy and Royal Sheen and Fremont and Kasserup and Palisade going fairly sweetly down the outside at the furlong peg, and Michael Malloy the leader now, and Red Siren is coming up on the outside of Palisade, and it's Michael Malloy and Palisade and Red Siren, Michael Malloy and Palisade, Michael Malloy and Palisade and Red Siren, the 3 of them in a photo.
Luther continued the 4-year-old run when he won the 1968 Wellington Cup, and Bill Skelton had his first winning ride in the event.
Past the 7 furlong peg, and Nick Pleaser still the leader. A length to Bee and Toe, followed by Bright Chief, who's getting every chance, followed by Goldie Boy. Terrific has gone up on the outside of it, and Lufa getting the run up on the inside. They get to the 6 furlong peg, and they're followed in by Tarim with You Dare right up alongside of these. A length further back on the inside is Empire King with Jen High, and they're followed in by Sail Away. And then they gallop round to the 5 furlong peg, and they're followed further back in the field then by Tatua. Tatua with Ironback, then Lady Wild on the outside of these, then Port Duty alongside of Lady Wild. They're followed in by fans. Geyserland is still back at the rear of the field. They make their way out of the back and at the 4 furlong peg, and Nick Pleasey still part of the field, and it's Nick Pleasey's gone away to lead by a length and a half at the moment from Bright Chief on the inside of Goldie Boy. Bee and Toe feeling the pressure, followed by Luther going beautifully in about 5th places, followed by Terrific, then Sail Away, Empire King still on the rail. They're followed then by Tarim drifting through the field. Jen High, there's Tartu in a wee bit of trouble as they round the bend on towards the 2.25 furlong peg, and Goldie Boy goes up to join the leader. At the 2 there's Nick Pleasey and there's Goldie Boy, and Bright Chief pulls out to go between that pair, and You Dare about 2 lengths away is followed then by Lufa galloping smartly into the picture, and they're followed then by Empire King. Bright Chief in front of the furlong, Lufa issuing a challenge and going like a winner, and there's Bright Chief and Lufa together, followed by You Dare. Ill Temper coming home but too late, and Lufa's gone to the front of the cup, and Lufa's got the cup 150 yards to go, and it's Lufa a length and a half to Bright Chief. Ill Temper 3rd a length away.
Bob Skelton added to his cup record at Trentham when he rode the 4-year-old City Court to win in 1969.
As they get to the mile with half the journey behind the Mill Tempo, moving up next on the outside of Calm Comet on the inner. Michael Molloy, three quarters of a length away, a length and a half. His Lordship followed on the outside, then by Wakama, and then two lengths for the back two. Noir Falou on the inside, and Tom Jones is on the outer. Just under seven to go in the Cup, and Mammoth still the leader from Kintyre, neck away on the rail. A length and a half further away, then is Spring Falou getting every chance with Aristocan up on the outside of these Gen High. Six furlongs left to go, then Roman Consul. There goes Native Diver up and round the outside into about third place, and they're followed by J. Ribbon Looper, tucked in on the rail with City Court three wide. A length further away to Highland Rebel, going well next on the inside rail. Parley D'Amour, then Tartua with Goldie Boy four wide, and El Tempo right up on the outside of these as they make their way out of the back, and four and a half to go. Calm Comet the next one. Michael Molloy is starting to make ground. Who's next on the outside is followed then by Proud Chief in a length to the back at the 4-2. His Lordship being checked a wee bit. Noir Falou goes up on the outside of him, and they're followed then by Le Danois, then a length and a half to Tom Jones at the rear. They make their way around on three furlongs left to go in the Cup, and Native Divers at the front. Native Diver the leader now, and there goes El Tempo. Must be five wide, but showing up on the outside. Harris Dock is right between that pair. They're followed then as they make their way on round the bend by Jen Hay, and they straighten up in two furlongs left to go, and Harris Dock has gone up to Native Diver, and City Court is three out, and El Tempo further out on the outside of these. They're followed by Jen Hay. Highland Rebel well back in the field is finishing well though, followed then by Spring Falou on the way on the outside. Here comes Wakamar and Tom Jones there also, but City Court has reached his head in front, and it's City Court from Native Diver. El Tempo, Spring Falou coming at them. City Court in front, and they go down to the line, and City Court has won the Cup. City Court has won an opponent, second, third and fourth between.
The fastest 2 miles ever run in New Zealand was registered when Il Tempo won the Cup in 1970. He'd won the Auckland Cup 3 weeks earlier and laid claims to being the top horse for that period over a distance. Noel Reardon again had the mount.
They make their way out of the straight, and nine furlongs left to go, and Mammoth in his usual role, he shows the way. Out by two lengths at the moment from Donald Mack, a length and a half. Johnny Cash one off the fence, followed by Ray Dan on the inside rail. They get to the mile peg, half the journey behind them. A length further away, Aristock the next one, Tom Jones the next one on the inside. Just over a length away, then Embassy, followed on the inside by Highland Rebel, Spring Falou on the outside of him. As they get to the seven furlong peg, on me the next one with Proud Chief, Jen High the rail, Wakamar, Gay Gabador a length, Lord Cheval and Il Tempo still at the back of the field, but starting perhaps to move just a wee bit, but still about 15 lengths from the leader. Down the back and just on six furlongs left to go now, and Mammoth is away in the lead. He's opened up about four lengths on the second horse, Donald Mack. A length and a half to Johnny Cash, going nicely in third, followed by Ray Dan still on the rail. A length and a half, Tom Jones. They start on the big bend with five to go, then Aristock, Embassy moving forward. Highland Rebel patiently ridden on the rail. A length further away, Spring Falou not far from them, followed by Onami, the inside rail. A length and a half, Proud Chief, Jen High, Il Tempo. He's starting to move up a wee bit, but by Jove, he's been pushed along to do it. He's got a long way to make up, and a length and a half, Gay Gabador, Wakamar at the rear of the field with Lord Cheval. They race round and just over three and a quarter furlongs to go, and Mammoth the leader, two lengths to Donald Mack, and there goes Aristock up on the outside of him. Johnny Cash and Ray Dan poking through along the inside rail. They're starting to pack up, and they're followed by Tom Jones and Proud Chief, the next one, and then further back on the inside, we've got El Tempo tucked in on the inside rail as they start the run home and come along with two to go. And Donald Mack, the first one to go up and into the lead, and it's Donald Mack with Aristock. Embassy taken to the outside. Highland Rebel, he's been patiently ridden all the way. Here comes Onami, taken out to the outside. Johnny Cash in behind them, and they're followed further back in the field by Gay Gabador, and they race along to the field. Oh, here's El Tempo bursting through the middle. Oh, what a terrific performance. El Tempo goes up and inside. Highland Rebel goes to the lead. El Tempo's won the money. El Tempo, oh, what a terrific horse this is. Highland Rebel is second, followed by Onami third, and they're followed by Johnny Cash, the next one home then, as they went over the finishing line.
And El Tempo's time was 3:16 and three quarters, and it became a new Australasian record. 1971 and another Cup winner. David Peake rode his first Wellington Cup victor in five-year-old Anson.
Just over nine furlongs to go. Trelay has taken the running by a length and a half now from Mammoth. A length for the back, then third place, and beautifully positioned all the way by Brian Andrews, the Spectre. A length for the back, Simon de Montfort is followed by Stimulator. Reva Durchie has to do it three wide all the way. Anson, the next one on the inside, rail at the mile peg into the back. They go there, followed then by Pep with Aristock on the outside. Princess Melee, the rail in Monastic, followed by Black Charm going around him. Akahau, the next one, is closely followed by his Lordship Artifice on the outside. And Belladin, three quarters of a length away at the back of the field. Down the far side in the cup and 6.5 to go. The South Islander, Trelay the leader from Mammoth up on the outside. Spectre galloping beautifully third on the rail. 6 furlongs left to go. Simon de Montfort then a length to Anson. Followed then on the outside by Arrivederci. Still three wide. It's followed then by Stimulate in the middle. Princess Malay going nicely on the rail. About 10 lengths from the leaders. 5 to go. And they're followed then by Pep, the next one. Akaha with Monastic Artifice on the outside of that pair. Followed then by Baladin. Then a long way further back. His Lordship just dropped out of it. They make their way around and a little over 4 to go. Trelay is still the leader. And it's Trelay from Mammoth, followed then in third place by Spectre. Simon de Montfort, 3/4 of a length away, a length to Anson. Stimulate in the river. Dirty moving closer to them, followed then by Aristoc making a run around them. So too is Pep, Princess Melee, the rail. There goes Monastic up on the outside of that pair. About 5 or 6 lengths from the leaders. It's a tightly packed field. Artifice goes wide on the outside, about 5 wide back in the field into Akaha and Belladin. They make the turn in a 2.25 furlongs left to go. And now Simon de Montfort has gone up to Trelay and headed them all off. And is followed then by Anson, but Simon de Montfort the leader. Spectre's bottled up in behind them. Princess Melee getting into the clear. Followed then on the outside by Aristoc. And Monastic about 3 or 4 lengths away. Just under a furlong left to go. Anson goes up on the outside of Simon de Montfort, followed by Princess Melee running about a wee bit. Anson's the one in command. And Anson's going away on the cut. Anson goes on to win at a length. Prince Melee third, a photo finish between Spectre and Simon de Montfort, there followed then by Stimulate, then Monastic, next is followed then by Aristotle.
There have been outsiders in the winner's circle on any race course, and there have been lucky jockeys who picked up a ride at the last moment. Such a horse was Simon de Montfort at Trentham in 1972, and such a jockey was Brian Dodds.
The big field of 21 makes its way into the back, and that's the mile rail, and Pago shows the way. Half the journey behind them, 2 lengths away behind the leader, Simon de Montfort, with a length of Snowboy. A length away to 4th Street, beautifully positioned, getting near to the 7th furlong peg. A length farther afield in his Riverview, followed by Subtle next on the inside, and Johnny Cash, then 2 lengths Star Trooper, followed on the inside rail by Quetta, sailing home, then Wurimu, followed then by Shanty. The next is Duty Free, who's going a nice race on the inside. They've gone past the 6th furlong peg. Classic is next, is followed by Anne Gable. A link farther back to Ribaldo, next on the inside of Josie Glow and Zorba, and Silver Knight, the favourite, is actually last as Shalanda goes round the outside of him. They leave the end of the back straight and just under 5 to go. Simon de Montfort is still the lead of the South Islander. Bob Skelton has Snowboy up on the outside. A length and a half into 4th Street, in a beautiful place on the outside as they get to the 4 furlong peg. They're being followed by Rel and Pago. Duty Free, our Riverview is there, and so too is Subtle, getting a split between horses as they make their way in with 3.5 to go. A length into Star Trooper, followed by Johnny Cash, sailing home, becoming prominent, followed then in behind them by Quetta, then Viceroy, followed by Wurimu, looking to improve along the inside rail. And I don't think any chance of the Melbourne Cup winner winning the Wellington Cup from there. He's got about 2 behind him. It may come past the 2 furlong peg. Simon de Montfort is the leader. 2 lengths away to Snowboy and Gable, looking to get the run on the fence, followed by Riverview. Johnny Cash going out after them. So, or Silver Knight, he's only about 5 lengths from the leader. Down past the furlong peg they come. Simon de Montfort in the lead, followed by Subtle on the outside. Johnny Cash farther afield. Duty Free, Silver Knight can't be in it, and they race down, and Simon de Montfort followed by Subtle. Simon de Montfort, Subtle, Simon de Montfort ahead away, Subtle. That's the way they've hit the line in the Wellington Cup. Duty Free would be third.
It didn't take David Peake long to ride his second Wellington Cup winner. Rustler justified his supporters' faith when he ran 3:20 3/4 in the last Wellington Cup over 2 miles in 1973.
Who's been wide on the track all the way, just over 5.25 to go, and they're followed by Topsy going up 3 out on the outside of Johnny Cash. Turi in a nice place on the inside of these with just under 5 to go. They start on the big bend, and they're followed then by Grogan, Golden Sam improving. There goes High Feet around the outside. A length farther afield then on the inside of these, he's got Wurimu. They're followed then by Apollo 11. He's been carted back through the field. Then Garner starting a run. Ribaldo starting to move around them too, and Fort Hagen dropped out to the back of the field. Just over 3.25 to go on the cup, and Simon de Montfort is still showing the way. 3 from home from Regan Rash, and Trelay has had the beautiful run. He's getting eased out from the fence now to get his run. There goes Golden Sam, the favourite, up to join them too, followed by Topsy getting a handier Regal Rash, and in behind them followed by High Vita and Ribaldo, back about 8 lengths from the leaders. They turn in, but galloping powerfully. They come along a furlong and 3/4 to go. Golden Sam has been claimed on the outside by Topsy, and Trelay still there on the inside. Simon de Montfort, Rustler looking to get clear over on the outside. Then Gunn gets out of the furlong peg. Topsy has a nose in front of Bob Skelton, pushing Trelay on. Is he finishing better? Trelay on the inside, and Glengown on the outside. Rustler the danger. Trelay from Rustler. Trelay, Rustler. Oh, they've hit the line. There's nothing in it. Trelay, Rustler, and Glengown flying on the outside.
And so to the Centennial Cup, January 1974, and Battle Heights joins the ranks of Wellington Cup winners that goes back 100 years.
And they're on their way from the 1,200 metre mark, and Magic Touch the Grey on the hour nerve from about number three. Inspire and Rose Millet are prominent in the early running. On Seed Out Wide on the track is taking up a prominent place, and so too is Mystic Dancer. Manchero fairly prominent too in the early running. Glen Gown has immediately dropped away to the back of the field. He's about two lengths behind the second to last horse, which is Kiermaier, and now Spire is going back to join them too. On Settling Down now, and On Seed with Bill Skelton has taken the lead in the early running, followed then by Manchero next on the inside, and Peg's Pride is prominent on the outer. They are the first three in remand up along the inside rail. It's closely attended then as they come along then by Manchero. In behind these then two Battle Heights, then Spa on the inside, Rose Millet just alongside of Spa. They're fairly tightly packed, and they're followed over on the outside of these then by Mogador. In behind these then is Woolaway Glen Gown, well back in the field as they race down past the 2,400 metre mark. And On Seed, written by Bill Skelton, there's Rasta Valley given rein to go up alongside and quicken the pace and take the lead. Rasta Valley on Settling Down now along the straight by two lengths from On Seed, followed by Spar going up to join it. A length away Remand, Peg's Pride on the outside of Remand, and little length Manchero. Battle Heights along the inside rail, just over a length away Rose Millet. Magic Touch the South Islander at the judge around to go, followed by Mystic Dancer. Brad and Lee on the outside of Woolaway, two away Kiermaier on the inside of Mogador, and the top weight Glen Gown at the back of the field, racing out of the straight now towards the Yipziger, towards the 1800 metre mark. And Rasta Valley's kicked away. He's opened up a break of about seven or eight lengths on Seed, a length and a half Remand, followed by Spa on the outside of Remand, a length and a half to Peg's Pride racing off the fence on the outside. Battle Heights in a beautiful spot on the inside rail. The leader has passed the 1600 metre mark. A length away Manchero, followed on the inside then by Rose Millet, patiently ridden. Magic Touch on the outside of it, and then a length and a half farther away, Mystic Dancer, Cradenly, followed by Woolaway, the rail, two away Mogador, followed by Glen Gown, starting to make a run from the back of the field. And Kiermaier a neck away. The leader's got out still by about 10. He must have a dozen lengths on them, 1,200 metres from home. Rasta Valley about 10 lengths away on Seed in second, placing a length and a half away. Remand on the inside, Peg's Pride, and they're followed then by Battle Heights, getting out from the fence to go up on the outside of Spa. 1,000 metres left to go. They start on the big bend out of the back straight, followed by Manchero next on the inside. They're followed by Woolaway over on the outside of these then. Now he's moving up a little now is Rose Millet, and they're closely followed by Cradenly, fairly well back in the field. The next one on the inside, Mystic Dancer, Glen Gown. He's about 12 lengths from the lead inside the 800 metre mark, but starting to unwind his run, followed by Kiermaier and Mogador at the back of the field. Rasta Valley came back to them with 6.50 left to go, and On Seed once again moves up alongside about a neck away, followed by Peg's Pride, third Remand, Battle Heights, followed by Rose Millet going around the outside. Kiermaier following real Rose Millet on the outside, and they're followed then by Manchero, going pretty well back about three places on the rail. They've made the swing in and down past the 400 metre mark. Peg's Pride has gone up to On Seed. Battle Heights goes up alongside of the pair of them, and they're followed then by Rose Millet and Glen Gown in the clear on the outside about two lengths of the lead. But Battle Heights and Rose Millet about to be tackled by Glen Gown. Peg's Pride fighting on fairly. Manchero getting into the clear, but Battle Heights from Manchero are the two that have drawn away. Battle Heights from Manchero, who's faltered a wee bit in the last 100 yards. Rose Millet the outside, but Battle Heights a comfortable win. A photo second and third, Manchero on the inside, or Rose Millet about a head away third, followed then by On Seed in the next. One home was Woolaway, and there followed by Mystic Dancer. Five lengths away, Peg's Pride, and there followed by Glen Cowan, who couldn't go on with the job.